the main criticism has come from the way you describe Elizabeth. Mm. And, you know, you use phrases about her: venomous, crazy, witch on wheels. You know, that she barked
all
this. I
did not say a witch on wheels is not about Elizabeth. These things are taken out of context. And when you read the story, just like you take the little tidbit about the extraordinary night and you take it out of
context.
Who
was the witch on wheels?
I was talking about passive-aggressive relationships. When a man doesn't stand up, in general, relationships in general, when a man doesn't stand up, the woman is often seen as a witch on wheels, often vilified, which incidentally is exactly what has happened to me.
Mm. But you were obviously referring to Elizabeth, though, right?
No, I'm talking about a relationship.
Who else did he have in his life who could have possibly been the witch on wheels?
I'm seen as a witch on wheels.
You are now, yeah.
Yeah. That's what happens in a dynamic. But I'm talking about a relationship in general.
But a lot of the flack you've been getting is because of some of these descriptive phrases you've used in connection or in a roundabout way about Elizabeth. Do you regret now putting this stuff in, given the way the media's latched onto it? Do you accept that when somebody's dead and can't answer back, it looks graceless?
I accept it looks graceless, yes. My intention is not to bash Elizabeth Edwards. It's never my intention. My intention was to tell the truth of the story for the 6 years that I saw it through my eyes. I saw Elizabeth through the eyes of John Edwards. He would tell me things. Other people would tell me things. I only met Elizabeth once.
So you based everything in the book that you say about her on what John Edwards told you?
Well, when you're in relationship with a married man, that's how you're going to receive the information
about
his marriage.
Right.